hottest realty market of India was undoubtedly NCR. It was not only the Millennium City Gurgaon which gave investors the highest returns. Dwarka Expressway became the new punting ground for both developers and buyers. Greater Faridabad clawed back and key sectors in Noida clocked 20% plus returns. Vasudha Sharma recaps the year that was and what could be.
For the property markets of the National Capital Region, 2012 was an eventful year to say the least. It had its share of hits and misses, triumphs and disappointments. The capital suburbs, Noida and Gurgaon, dominated headlines throughout the year.
The land acquisition problems, which flared, in which we started understanding that you could not even trust what the authorities and what the government has given, which generally would be what you would trust implicitly. When even the foundations of that land acquisition were questioned, I think that was probably one of the most eventful and a learning experience for us, and I think probably shook the real estate market very dramatically also in a negative sense.
Noida Extension, now rechristened Greater Noida West, was hyped as North India's next big affordable housing destination. But land acquisition controversies, followed by a court-imposed construction ban, left thousands of home buyers in the lurch. Construction resumed once the NCR Planning Board cleared the Greater Noida Master Plan. But the troubles at Greater Noida West are far from over. Cancellation letters, demand letters, banks freezing loans are just some of the issues that buyers here continue to battle.
One of the major concerns that I have, like I said, is the financial health of the builders who have already taken money. What have they done with that money? The money was not in escrow, so we do need some sort of an auditing system to make sure that that money of the buyers is safe with the builders. The second one, in terms of land acquisition, I think it's going to be a painful and long drawn out process.
The year 2012 also saw Gurgaon, one of India's best performing realty markets, hit a dry patch quite literally. Gurgaon's booming real estate industry was brought to a standstill after the Punjab and Haryana High Court imposed a blanket ban on the use of groundwater to construct. Projects worth crores were halted for weeks. Developers pinned the blame on local authorities for failing to deliver basic infrastructure, and the local administration scrambled to damage control. Today, the Haryana Urban Development Authority is supplying lakhs of liters of treated sewage water to developers to build homes in Gurgaon. But Gurgaon's underlying chronic problems of water shortage and non-existing sewage networks are yet to be addressed. 2012 also saw Gurgaon getting its third master plan in the last 5 years. Gurgaon Manesar Urban Complex Master Plan 2031 created 7 new sectors, 3 new commercial belts and 2 industrial zones. All SEZ projects were scrapped and Gurgaon's population target was raised to 42 lakhs. All the new residential and commercial areas that were created lie along the Dwarka Expressway route.
Oh, Dwarka Expressway is going to be the new center of Gurgaon. When it is inside Gurgaon connected, I think there should be at least 50% rise in price. And when it is connected to Delhi, I think there should be a 100% rise in price.
But for the Dwarka Expressway, along which this new Gurgaon will evolve, the year 2012 was quite a non-starter. This 150-kilometer long alternate link between Delhi and NH8 in Gurgaon missed 3 deadlines in 2012. Projects here are being sold out within days, but chunks of the expressway are still incomplete due to pending litigation. But while the Dwarka Expressway ride remained rather bumpy in 2012, the opening of the much-anticipated Yamuna Expressway gave a fillip to the Greater Noida market. 3 government changes, bloody land acquisition battles and much political mudslinging later, the Yamuna Expressway connecting Greater Noida to Agra was finally thrown open to the public in August 2012. Massive townships, hotels, entertainment hubs, but no airport. How will 2013 look for the Yamuna Expressway realty market?
Affordable housing in India, even if we all put together the private-public partnership or private developers, if we keep working hard for next 15 to 20 years, we can't still meet the demand supply gap. So the best thing about Yamuna Expressway is it has got a huge availability of affordable housing. So it has to do well.
For the national capital, 2012 was a year of big policy changes. Circle rates were hiked by as much as 200% for residential colonies. So expect to pay more for a home in Delhi in 2013. Delhi's archaic farmhouse policy was also liberalized. The Delhi government's bonanza also included regularizing unauthorized colonies and illegal farmhouses at several locations. But the big dampener was the move to ban property sales through transfers of general power of attorney. All property deals after October 2011 through GPAs were declared illegal in an attempt to plug the flow of black money. Despite the liquidity crunch and the high interest rates, the property markets of the National Capital Region were definitely the place to be for buyers and investors in 2012. Micro markets like Dwarka Expressway put on a stunning performance, while in Gurgaon, the Golf Course Extension Road, Sona Road gives solid returns. Markets like Noida Expressway, Noida Extension also performed well because of the affordability tag. So as we kickstart 2013, expect another action-packed 12 months in the NCR region. In New Delhi, Vasudha Sharma for NDTV. We'll be right back.